I think one of the mistakes that people make is that somehow what's the impact tomorrow is going to have a huge cumulative effect. And I'm actually kind of surprised that people say having an uncompetitive tax system would be good for America. You're going to see companies doing things in the short run, like increasing wages and a bunch of stuff like that, or one-time bonuses. And we may do something. We're going to announce it sometime later. But over time, that retained capital will be used to grow businesses, R&D, hire people, wages, competition. And over time, it'll be very good for America.
That was J.P. Morgan Chase Chairman and CEO Jamie Dimon talking with me yesterday on the major impact of the tax reform plan in my Fox Business exclusive. Joining us now to talk more about that is EY America's Tax Vice Chairman Kate Barton. Kate, good to see you. Thanks so much for joining us.
It's nice to be here, Maria.
What's your take on the tax plan? What should we be thinking about in terms of what business is focusing on in terms of adapting to these new rules?
Well, we're really excited that it happened, and now I would say everyone is digesting it and really trying to figure out how does it apply to their companies. Public companies right now are consumed with trying to get it correctly stated in their financial statements. It's a lot of work.
Okay.
Okay. Tell us on one big part of this tax plan is repatriation, and you are the expert. EY is the expert on this thing. What is the C-suite telling you as to how they're going to deploy those funds that are coming back?
Right. So there's a lot of new sources of capital, right? You're going to get the cash back on the repatriated taxes, the repatriated earnings. And then you also have just the more capital by virtue of the rate going from 35 to 21. So those two new sources of capital, I think companies are going to customize what they do in terms of how they spend that. So already we've seen some companies say they're going to give back some of it to their employees through bonuses. And they're doing that, trying to get that paid. So under the tax rules, it gets deducted in last year. And then some of them are going to do share buybacks. Some will end up doing capital expenditures because of the 100% bonus depreciation.
Yes.
So I think each one will take a different tack depending on what they are. And I think some of them will do M&A activity.
Yeah, I think Jamie made the point yesterday that we will see maybe some stock buyback. But the good part about this will be capital redeployment, which will create jobs.
Absolutely.
And M&A is projected to be another great year, 2018, 17.
And he said that, too. He said,
yeah,
we're hearing a lot of M&A chatter. I have no doubt that we're going to see more deals this year, and it's going to really pick up. It was slow last year because of the uncertainty, but you saw the animal spirits begin to take hold in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
What
like
about
it.
The benefits, because we talked so much about, even before the deal got done, about the benefit to smaller businesses in this country. And with the, at least the cut or the benefit to the pass-through entities, what do you see happening there? Because the Treasury is going to take a year or maybe even 2 years to write the rules for that tax cut, which actually expires in 2025.
Absolutely. So I think for really small pass-through organizations, it's a good thing. But anybody over $400,000 or $500,000 of income, they're going to look at, is the pass-through the right vehicle for them, or should they convert to C corp? And so there's going to be a lot of planning on what is the right choice of entity,
which would actually potentially mean a bigger benefit to the economy as a whole, because that is permanent. So you have businesses that won't be grappling with a tax break that expires.
Exactly.
But one quick question on the individual side. I wonder whether we'll see, now that this is a reality, we had so much debate before the tax plan went into effect about state and local deductions, whether they should stay in or out. Now that it's there, are we to anticipate the states reacting to that and making some changes in their policy, New York, New Jersey, some other
states? We're already hearing rumors that New York is trying to turn it into charitable donations.
Right, to offset some of that.
But is that going to work?
Governor Cuomo talked about it in his State of the State address.
He says he wants to sue the federal government.
Yeah.
It could work technically, but I would imagine that there'll be a quick reaction to something like that. But I do think that there'll be a knock-on effect by a lot of the states, especially the higher tax states. You know, will there be an employer tax? You know, will they take some of their income tax and recast it in a different way?
As payroll taxes.
And so that's an option. So I think we'll see more of that. I mean, and they're already acting quickly.
Yeah, are you hearing that in the major affected states like New York, New Jersey?
New York, for
California?
Sure, definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what you're hearing in the C-suite.
Oh, yes, absolutely. I mean, people want them to react.
But you wonder how the IRS is going to react, and will they allow that kind of treatment, changing it to a payroll tax, changing it to charitable donations as opposed to actually paying taxes?
I think payroll tax might be something that is more, you know, substantial, and so we'll see. We'll see what they do.
Kate, great to see you. Thanks so much for your insights.
Thank you.
Kate Barton from EY this morning.